So, the story of Icarus. Icarus was the son of the master craftsman Daedalus. Daedalus was the guy who built the labyrinth that the Minotaur was in. Do you guys know that story?
Yes.
Cool. So, Daedalus and Icarus are trapped, locked into the labyrinth, and Daedalus wants to escape, so he builds these wings out of, wax and feathers for himself and his son in order to escape. But because they're made out of wax and feathers, Daedalus warns Icarus, don't fly too close to the sea, or you may drown. Don't fly too close to the sun, or the wax will melt. The wings will be ruined, and you will drown. So, on the day that they are escaping from the labyrinth, they put their wings on, fly away. Icarus is so overwhelmed with how awesome it is to be flying over the sea that he flies too high, flies too close to the sun, the wings melt, he falls into the sea, and he dies. Tragic. So, what we're going to be examining today is two questions. Was Icarus motivated by virtue or vice? You know, was he a hero for using the wings to escape the labyrinth? Should we admire his daring in being a human that flies? Or should we pay more attention to how foolish he was for not heeding his father's warning, for flying too close to the sun, ultimately resulting in his death? So, in examining these questions, was Icarus heroic or foolish, we can look at different artist portrayals of Icarus. We're going to look at a couple examples of images of Icarus and see what, we'll talk about what the artist is saying about Icarus. So, looking at this painting of Icarus, what do you see? What's going on? What do you think the artist is saying? And what in the painting makes you say that? What's your evidence?
Looks like a god.
How so?
He's flying towards the heavens, and he's got his glowing wings and his like rippling muscles, which I'm pretty sure he lived in a tower. Like, unlikely that he looked like that. Unless he was dead. And he's, you know, got beautiful hair that's like billowing around. He looks like a god. On the ceiling of a cathedral or something.
Yeah. Sistine Chapel worthy. So if he looks godlike, what do you think the artist thinks about Icarus? Hero or fool?
Hero.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cool. And, you know, this painting doesn't say Icarus was a hero anywhere, but you can tell just by the tone, the mood of the painting, what the artist is arguing for. What about these two? Let's start with the one on the left. Same questions. What do you guys see?
Fool.
Or on the left.
Fool, why?
Yeah, because he's falling into the ocean. It looks like he's not having a good time.
He's pretty stressed out.
He's like breaking. Right.
And he's screaming like, oh.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely showing like the tragic piece of it.
Yeah. Absolutely. What about the one on the right? How does that compare? Oof. Hero or fool, and why?
I think hero, just because of the way, like, it's like he's like got this like beautiful form and beautiful wings. At the same time, he's like raising his hands up to like a god. It kind of makes me, like, I don't know.
Part of, like, the other one as well, it's like he thinks he's a god, but he's not. And in the other one as well, he was kind of like trying to go up to the heavens and like holding his arms up, and he thinks he's a god, but he's not, which is, I think, it makes him think as a fool in some ways as well.
Yeah, like he's still reaching for the heavens. He's not quite there yet.
He doesn't belong.
This is foolish. I believe he could be a god, but he's like actually a full human.
Yeah, it can maybe be a little bit of both. I wonder. His wings look pretty nice. Not falling yet. Doesn't look as miserable as the one on the left. Here on the left, there's Daedalus sending off Icarus. Thoughts on that one? It's maybe not as clear, but yeah. It's still read into it. What do you guys think?
I think kind of foolish. He doesn't really know. It looks like he doesn't really know he's doing, but it doesn't really show like the result.
Yeah.
So
that's a little awkward.
Yeah.
And on the right, you have Daedalus instructing Icarus. Looks like before they took off into the air with their wings. What does Icarus look like?
It's like a foolish.
What am I doing here?
So young.
Kind of like ignoring his father's commands. So don't fly too high, don't fly too low.
Mm-hmm. Both of these look really young, like innocent.
Mm-hmm.
Not like you would know better on this.
Yeah.
Like foolish. Mm-hmm. Like more like a innocence thing than just like simple foolishness.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe he didn't know better. Yeah, cool. We've got a couple more. Inez, what do you think about this one?
Haven't heard me yet.
Foolish, because it's really dark and looks like he's gonna die.
Yeah, looks pretty dreary. Doesn't look like he's flying. Yeah, I'd say so.
It's interesting it's so dark because he dies because he flies too close to the sun. Mm-hmm.
But it's really dark. I think the darkness is kind of like
the sea. Yeah, it's a metaphor.
Because when we fit to the sea, he just drowns, so he's going into darkness.
Yeah.
The darkness.
Yeah.
I think this one is interesting because he's like reaching and falling, and the other one, or like some of the other ones, he was just falling.
Mm-hmm.
But this one, it's like kind of depicting both sides. But like it is looks foolish.
Knowing that it's the album cover of Between the Buried and Me also gives me a little bit of a hint. I don't know if you guys are familiar with that band, but they're a screamo band.
Cool. I got one more for you. This might be my favorite. So what do you think about this one?
Oh my god.
Yeah, for sure.
I would agree.
Look at his abs.
or his like the bulging vein in his calf in his thigh. I don't like looking at that.
I don't either. Compared
to the fat
monkey
who's being thrown off the dad.
They grow up so fast.
Yeah, like
change races.
Yeah, get a thumb as well. So, yeah, I think this one looks heroic, I'd say so. It looks pretty epic.
Going out to ladies.
No longer, not after drowning in the sea. So Icarus is a classic example, being a cautionary tale of hubris, of Icarus had so much pride, he was so excited to be a human that's flying in the sky, that built up his pride, and he disregarded his father's warnings. And it ended in his death. The Greeks used this as a lesson of moderation, saying, you know, have pride, be proud of yourself, but don't be Icarus. Don't allow it to, don't let your pride result in your total downfall. So are heroes born of a life lived moderately, or do heroes become heroes because they push themselves farther than other people are willing to go? And at what point will that, will pushing yourself to become a hero result in your downfall, and result in you being labeled as foolish? These are some questions that people looking at Icarus ask, and they're questions that we looking at Christopher McCandless will ask. Was Christopher McCandless a hero? Was he a fool?